Grace and peace, everybody. Welcome to Sabbath School Study Group. I'm Chris Bailey. We're grateful that you're with us today. Remember, you can always see and do more at changeministry.org. Enjoy those studies there. If you feel impressed, we appreciate your support to this ministry. But above all, believe what the Lord is sharing, because today we're going to be talking about not too hard for you. As we've been looking in Deuteronomy, the call to choose life. Yes, it's not too hard for you to choose life when you understand what we're going to study right now. Father, I pray that you would speak to our hearts, that you would make the crooked places straight, but make the rough places plain by understanding the how and not just the what when it comes to living for you. Amen. Yes, Deuteronomy is a call to a higher standard, and that standard is simply to be close to Jesus, to being in love with the Father through Jesus Christ. But recognizing that vaulted height, those high places, if you will, we're not supposed to get there on our own. In fact, what we've got to understand is that by the power of his Spirit, we're to live the life of God. In fact, Jesus is easy to love when his love is in you. In other words, if you've got the gas, it's not a big deal for your engine to run with the right fuel in it. If the Spirit is working in you, it's not just easy, it's impossible for you to not do what God has called us to do. How do we know that? Look at the word of the Lord. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse number 11. It says, "For this commandment, this call, which I command thee this day, it is not hidden from thee, neither is it far off." This is interesting. The Lord tries to get some proximity, focusing not just on the what, but the how. See, we've already dealt with how all his commands are calls, and they're calls to be closer to him. And what he's saying here is like, you know, that may sound like an intimidating thing, you know, to get close to me or to get close to God. But the fact of the matter is that this is not a big distance. This is not as big of a gap as you might think. Not again because of us, but because of how close he is to us. Therefore, when it comes to the will of God, the command of God, the way may seem very hard from our perspective, but from his, it's not far from us. Because when we finally see where he wants this will and he wants this power to be, you'll recognize it's not far at all. Keep reading, because down in verse 12 through 13, he says, "This is not in heaven that thou shouldest say, who shall go for us up to heaven and bring it unto us that we may hear it and do it? Neither is it beyond the sea, neither is his call that thou shouldest say, who shall go over the sea for us and bring it unto us that we may hear it and do it." There are a few ways that we could understand this text. In other words, we could be dealing from the cognitive aspect in that I'm not dealing with people from a point of ignorance. Israel knew the law. Israel knew the what, but they had not really grasped the how, clearly because of the fact that they broke that covenant. That was even in the days of Jesus. A lack of knowledge was not necessarily the issue. It was not a lack of knowing what, it was how they were going about doing it. They were doing it by their own strength, their own power, their own will, and they failed just like you and I will fail if we miss this important point. Jesus is not hard to love when his love is where? In you. That brings us to verse number 14. Where he says, "But the word is very nigh unto thee." How close? In thy mouth. But even closer than that, in thy heart. And because it's in your heart, and if it is in your heart, that thou mayest do it. Love that word mayest. This whole series might call it the mayest series, because we're trying to understand what we mayest do. And today we're focusing on how that happens. We mayest do it, if you will, because it's in our heart. It's the fuel within. It's the fire within. And it's not just in the mind. It's not just by force of will in the hand, but because it's burning in the heart, you're going to see the flame. It's an exothermic reaction. In an endothermic reaction, the energy is released, and it's something that happens within the organism or within something. But in an exothermic reaction, you see the fire, you see the flame. Therefore, you feel the flame. You know it's hot, not just in a cognitive aspect, but you see it there with your own eyes. You feel it with your own hands. This is what Jesus wants to do. And this is the work through his Spirit in us that will affect this kind of change. I want to pray for that. I want to have this kind of reaction so I can have that kind of impact so that others can see his love, not just by what I'm saying, but by what I'm doing. If you want that, pray for that. And I hope today that you recognize that Jesus is easy to love when Jesus is in you.